Ayan, so magandang gabi po sa inyong lahat. So nandito na naman po tayo dito sa ating YouTube channel. So maraming salamat po sa pagsubaybay sa ating mga videos na inilalabas po sa ating YouTube channel, The Nurse Trader TV. Ako po si John Molina at your service. At nandito po tayo ngayon sa Qatar. And ang araw po ngayon ay September 24, 2020. Dito po ay alas 10:26 PM ng gabi. So, ayan. So, actually itong video na ito, pahabol, ito lang po ay we will going to talk about merely the history of the Philippine Stock Exchange. So nakikita po natin sa screen po natin ngayon. So history, ano ba yung significant na magiging topic natin ngayong gabi na ito? Bakit kailangan nating aralin yung history ng Philippine Stock Exchange sa Pilipinas specifically, and how we actually how we left behind by our co-nations in ASEAN, because you know nagsimula pala tayo nung 1927, but then as far as I know meron lang pong 2% na registered traders sa Pilipinas. So bakit po kaya kumpara or ikumpara natin yung data ng mga traders sa ibang bansa tulad ng ating mga co-nations sa ASEAN ay nasa 10 to 20% po ng kanilang population ay talagang nag-i-engage po sa kanilang stock exchange. So mamaya titignan po natin. So ano yung mga possibilities, bakit po, and then ano ba yung dapat gawin natin for us to start this kind of business that we have. And ipapakita ko rin po paano po ako nagsimula, how I started, and ano yung naging capital ko. So million ba ang kailangan para magtagumpay dito sa stock exchange? So titignan po natin mamaya, ipapakita ko po yung ginawa po nating history account, ika nga, sa ating stock exchange. So una, so we will going to read about the history of the Philippine Stock Exchange. So this credit po sa author po nito, si James Rada Jr. This is from www.sampling.com. So according po sa kanya, the Philippine Stock Exchange first appeared in 1993, but its history runs much longer. The exchange was a merger of the Manila Stock Exchange and the Makati Stock Exchange. So dalawa pala yung stock exchange natin hanggang sa nagkaroon po ng merge ng dalawang stock exchange na ito, which is the Manila and the Makati. So the merger also served as a symbol to a country that had seen its share of political division, that the nation could act in the singular direction. Tama nga naman. So hanggang sa naisilang na po yung Philippine Stock Exchange. So iisa na lang po yung platform or yung stock exchange na meron po tayo sa ating bansa. Tulad po sa mga ibang bansa, iisa lang din po. So nandyan po sa US, Nasdaq. Ayan, so di, sa Pilipinas, Philippine Stock Exchange. So ayan po. So kailan po ba nagsimula ang ating stock exchange na business na ito? So the Manila Stock Exchange was founded August 8, 1927 by 5 US businessmen. So dinala pala sa atin ang business na ito ng mga kano, ng mga Amerikano. It was in the Insular Life Building on Plaza Cervantes, Binondo, Manila. So ang founder po ay si W.P.G. Elliot, W. Eric Little, Gordon W. Mackay, John J. Russell, and Frank W. Ewan ko po kung anong ibig sabihin ng mga acronym po na yan. Wakefield said that they wanted a stock exchange that would serve the public practice ethical standards and uphold good business. So yun po yung sinasabi natin. Hindi po sinabi dyan and uphold a good gambling business. Hindi po siya gambling ang stock exchange. Ito po ay isang klase ng business. So they also claim that trading in stock would stimulate the Philippine economy. So yun po yung sinasabi natin na not only we are investing for us to earn, but we are helping also our nation to boost the economy. So nakakatulong tayo sa ekonomiya ng Pilipinas by just investing, by trading in the stock market. So they also claimed, yun nga sabi, that it would boost the Philippine economy. The Manila Stock Exchange moved to Pasig in 1992. So, ayan. So, the younger Makati Stock Exchange was founded. So, later, founded na po yung Makati Stock Exchange noong May 27, 1963. It too had 5 founding members. So, sa aking nababasa, mukhang mga Pilipino po ang founder ng Makati Stock Exchange. Alam naman natin gaano kayaman ang Makati since then. So, Miguel Campos, Bernard Gaberman, Aristio Lat, Eduardo Ortigas, and Hermenegildo B. Reyes. Because the Philippines already had an operating stock exchange, there was opposition to a second one. The exchange, which was in the Insular Life Building in Makati, did not begin operating until November 16, 1965, and in 1971, it moved to its own building on Ayala Avenue in Makati. So, nagkaroon tuloy ng competition. So, though the Philippines had 2 stock exchanges, they both traded the same stocks. So, nagkaroon po ng competition. So, duplication also, but they had different policies and different members and different stock prices. So, yun po yung naging hindi po maganda kasi kailangan sa isang bansa, may isa lang. Kasi pagdating po sa prices, nagkakaiba po sila. So, yun po yung nagiging competition na nangyayari. So, it soon became evident that the country needed only a single stock exchange. So, ayun na nga po. Noong panahon po ng ating Presidente Fidel Ramos led the effort to unite the 2 exchanges as one. So, the Philippine Stock Exchange was founded July 14, 1992. Grabe, isang buwan lang pala bago ako naisilang na found yung stock exchange. So, and by December 23, both the Makati and the Manila exchanges agreed to become part of it. So, yun na nga po, naisilang na po ang Philippine Stock Exchange. Nung panahon, where the first board of governors for the Philippine Stock Exchange was elected, March 20, 1993. And they were the president of exchange and 14 members broker. Eduardo de los Angelos was the first president of the Philippine Stock Exchange, and Eduardo C. Lim was the first chairman of the board. So, just short of the year later, the Securities and Exchange Commission granted the stock exchange its license to operate as a securities exchange. So, ayun po. So, nagkaroon na po ng unification po talaga. So, naging as one yung stock exchange po, which is now the Philippine Stock Exchange. So, in 1998, the Securities and Exchange Commission made the Philippine Stock Exchange a self-regulatory organization which allows it to create its own rules and impose penalties on members. So, ayan po. So, yun lamang po yung brief na history ng ating Philippine Stock Exchange. So, nagsimula pala tayo ng dalawang stock exchange, yung Makati at Manila. So, right then, nagkaroon ng competition, and then later on it was seen that it's really not good way of yung competition na iyon pagdating sa mga prices, stock prices, ay ginawan po ng paraan para mag-unite ang dalawang stock exchange na ito, and then the Philippine Stock Exchange born. So ayun po, so yun po yung ating history, brief history. So bakit ba kailangan nating mag-invest sa stock market? So siguro naman po marami pong klaseng business ang pwede nating gawin. But then sabi nga there are ways on how we will going to utilize our funds. There are a lot of ways on how to invest our money, but you know, the para sa akin, isa sa pinaka best na way or medium para ma-reach natin yung goal natin is through Philippine Stock Exchange. Marami na pong naging successful if we will going to read those who been successful in this industry. So siguro naman hindi na tayo nahuhuli sa mga balita pagdating sa mga sinasabi nating business tycoon pagdating po sa stock exchange. Nandiyan na po si Manny Villar, how we started in Japsia, and so on and so forth. So makikita po natin yung successful stories po nila, and then other millionaires na nagsimula lamang po sa maliit na kapital, and then later it was became you know, unexpected a million and billion of peso that they earned from the stock market. So ngayon, so ayan, so nabibigyan po tayo ng idea bakit ba kailangan nating mag-invest sa stock market. So ngayon, bibigyan ko naman kayo ng paano ba nagsimula si Mr. John Molina sa kanyang karera sa stock market. So this is not to promote myself, but then this is just to encourage lalong-lalo na po sa ating mga OFW na talaga alam nyo po gaano po ka-treasure or ka-precious yung pera na pinaghihirapan natin, and we wanted just only to put in the right platform, in the right business yung ating pera. Huwag na po tayong magpanipaniwala sa mga easy money scheme na tinatawag, kasi I've been there already, I've tried that already, but then I was not been successful in that area. Though alam naman natin may mga naging successful, but then later on nalaman din pala natin na ganun pala. So sabi ko, it's not about what kind of maybe what kind of business we will going to pursue, but of course whatever business that we have, we should have that dedication first, and then of course kailangan po nating mag-invest sa education. Bakit? So napaka-importante po na pag-aralan po ang aspeto, yung fundamentals ng ating pinapasok ng anumang pong business. So if alam po natin na later on it would be a challenge for us to proceed, lalo-lalo na yung mga platform na sinasabi po nila pagdating po sa pyramiding, sa sinasabi po nila na networking. Kung nauna ka sa business na yan, malamang na malamang you will become a successful millionaire. But sooner and later, alam naman natin how the business will run. And then later on, yung mga pinakamababa sa pinakamababa, hindi na nila nagagawa yung nagawa mo. And then it was stuck already, and then the business ends. That's it. So yun po yung nagiging problema po kung hindi po natin pinaplano kung saan po natin ilalaan yung ating mga pinaghihirapang pera. So I just wanted to encourage everyone. So this is still in your decision kung gusto nyo pong sumabak po sa industry na ito. But I encourage you, lalo-lalo po sa ating mga OFW, to start And you know, napakadali pong mag-start. Ang dami pong platform sa Pilipinas na pwede nyo pong pasukan. Nandyan po ang Call Financial, nandyan po ang BDO, nandyan po, madami po. Kailangan nyo lang pong i-search sa internet saan ba ang pinaka-best at pinaka-accessible para sa atin. So, it's really, you know, freedom for us to choose kung saan tayo gustong mag-invest or saan po tayong platform na mag-proceed. So, ayan. So, ipapakita po natin yung ating ginawa pong ayan. Ano ba ang pinagsimulan po ng inyong lingkod? So, ayan po. Makikita nyo po sa taas. Ito po yung capital po natin. So, as you will see, bakit po kailangan ng ganito? For us, yan. So, kailangan po nating ma-motivate sa mga... Okay? So, kailangan pong ma-motivate po tayo by this kind of, you know, of representation. So, napakahalaga na minomonitor po natin ang ating earnings. Okay? So, para po sa kaalaman ng lahat, nag-start po ako sa stock market noong June 2019 sa halagang 150,000 pesos. So, actually, this is spare lamang po ito ng aking ipon. Actually, first na ipon po namin sa bangko ito. But actually, the sum of its portion is invest din po namin sa MP2. Later on, we will going to talk about MP2. And naka 1 year na rin po kami na mag-asawa sa MP2. And then, isa pong platform na nakita po namin to invest our money is the stock market. So, we started at 150,000 pesos. So, titignan po natin paano ba naging, tignan natin yung grow ng ating pera and how, paano po tayo kumita dito. So, as time goes by, so, kailan ba nagkaroon ng pag-asa ang ating 150,000 pesos? So, ayan po. So, noong June 2019, nag-invest po tayo ng 150,000 pesos. So, yung unang buwan, kumita na po tayo ng 1,000 pesos. So, not bad. So, sa mga bangko, yung 150,000 pesos niyo po, kikitain niyo po yan ng siguro isang taon, if I'm not mistaken. But, in the stock market, we earned it at in just 1 month. And then, nung July 2019 po, okay, so, bigla pong nagkaroon po tayo ng wrong entry, ika nga. So, hanggang sa nag-negative, meron po tayong loss na 15,000. So, yung pera na natin ay naging 135,000 pesos. So, and so on. And habang tumatagal po, as you see, puro negative na po ang ating port. So, hanggang sa nung December 2019, sabi ko, mukhang hindi para sa akin yung business na ito. But, kasi alam nyo po ba, almost 50% na po, yeah, it's more than 50% ang loss ko sa 150,000 in invest namin. Sabi ko, this is not for me. So, kailangan ko ng give up. But then, sabi ko, siguro may kulang. Alam nyo po ba kung ano? In this month, hindi po talaga ako nag-aaral tulad ng ginagawa ko ngayon na talagang as much as possible in a day, meron akong nalalaman na bago sa strategies, indicators, fundamentals, analysis, technical, lahat. So, kailangan meron tayong tinatawag na dinadigest kada araw para at least matuto tayo how we're going to run this business. So, ayun nga po, ginamit po natin hanggang sa bumababa po yung loss natin. So, naging 59,000 na lang po yung loss natin. So, So by that time, actually itong account na ito ay joint account po namin ng aking asawa, sa aking magandang asawa, supportive na asawa. So joint account po namin, that time tinatanong na niya po kung magkano na po ang kinikita ko sa stock market. Kasi nag-expect po siya na in just 3 months, lalago po yung pera po namin. But hindi ko po sinasabi na we're already losing our money. But it's a paper loss. Kasi nga po, hindi ko pa po binebenta yung mga ininvestan ko dito. Kasi actually hindi po ako marunong mag-entry sa anong stock market company ang pasukan ko. Minsan ang pinipili ko noon yung mga maliliit ang price kasi nga akala ko madaming shares ang pwedeng bilhin, then you will see the history and it came from piso like that, and you will earn if you will and if the stock price will reach this one. So yun po yung mga kaisipan ko po without thinking about some fundamentals, some of the technical analysis that we have now. So ayun po, so bumababa po. Hanggang nung February, nag-start na po yan. So, bumababa. And then, in this period po, sinacrifice ko po si 35,000. So, dahil may 115,000 na ako, I have to sell this one already to buy a stock na alam kong kikita ko ng makakabawi ako. And then, that was the time na sabi nating jackpot is jackpot. So, meron pong jackpot po talaga sa stock market. So, sabi ko, this is it. Sabi ko, this will be a milestone. This will be a unang step to boost or to grow our money. So, ayan po, kumita po tayo ng 10,000, not only 10,000, but it's 45,000 pesos. So, now, kumikita na po tayo from the capital ng 10,000 pesos. And nung nagsimula na po tayong matuto ng mga technical analysis, we tried already a daily trading hanggang sa every month po nung April, kumita na ulit tayo ng 20,000. So ayan po, nag-grow na po ang ating pera. So hanggang sa naging this is based on the capital dito sa side na ito, annual gain. So, hanggang sa naging 250,000 na yung pera natin. So, if we will compute, 100,000 na yung kita natin from 150,000 nung May. So, hanggang sa nagka-pandemic. So, these months were the months that the prices nag-gap down po ang lahat ng mga companies. So, ayan po, nag-start po tayong sumalo sa baba. So, hanggang sa biglang taas po sila, and then you will see already how our money grows already. So, merong time dito sa July na nag-loss tayo sa tawag dito, sa isang stock natin na hinawakan, but then nakabawi pa rin tayo ng August, and then now this is it. So yung 150,000 natin, ang kita na po natin is 520,000 pesos. If you will compute that one, that is more than 400%. Let's see how much in percent na kita natin in just actually it's if you will see September ngayon, June 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 months. So, yung 520,000 divided by 150,000. So, that is 346% na grow ng ating pera. Sa, tignan nyo, sa banko po, hindi po natin yun makukuha. Hindi po natin yun makukuha. Kahit ilang taon po yan. So, ayan, titignan po natin yung graph natin. How we started. Paano po tayo nalugmok and paano tayo bumangon. So, yun lamang po yung istorya na pinaghahawakan ko bakit naging motivated po akong magpursu sa business na ito. And we're planning to invest more, to add up a capital, more capital for us to aim more for our future, especially for our children. And you know, pwede po tong ipamana sa ating mga anak. So napaka-importante po mga ka-traders sa ating mga kababayan natin, sa mga OFW, na alam nyo po, hindi po mahirap ang business na ito. This is just about being patient, being motivated, and then kailangan meron din po tayong tiwala sa ating sarili at sa Diyos. So yun lamang po yung ating pangahawakan. At of course, education ay napaka-importante sa anuman pong klase ng business. Kailangan mong pag-aralan ng maigi ang business na tatahakin po natin. So yun lamang po yung ating sabi ko nga footprints sa business arena na ito, sa trading and also investing. So ngayon po sa ating portfolio, I have a portion of my account sa long term po siya. So meron po akong hinahawakan for long term, and then meron po akong pang daily trade. So for us to get a cash flow, kailangan po nating magkaroon ng buying power para po magkaroon po tayo ng cash flow. So dapat meron po tayong daily plan to execute. So yun po yung napaka-importante, mga ka-trader. So ayun po. So maraming salamat po sa pakikinig, sa nawa po ito po ay nagbigay po sa inyo ng kalinawan and of course encouragement. Sana hindi po tayo mawala ng pag-asa in whatever challenges and whatsoever failures that we face in our lives. You know, in every problems we encounter, there always be a solution. And also, you know, if we have that perseverance to face this problem, and we will uphold our dreams, makakamit po natin anuman pong mga pangarap po yan. So we're free to dream, actually, but it's only the step on how we're going to reach. That's yung pagkakaiba po natin, dun po tayo nagkakaiba. So anyway, paano man pong paraan, kung paano natin kamtin ang ating mga pangarap, make sure na stick pa rin po tayo sa tama. And of course, we should be guided by by professionals like that and advisor for you to be successful as your mentor, kung ano man po yung ibibigay niya pong suggestion. So napaka-importante po yun. So maraming salamat po. Nawa po subscribe niyo po ang ating YouTube channel, and later on madami pa po tayong pag-uusapan. And nawa nabigyan ko po kayo ng kahit paano idea and hint kung kailangan na bang magsimula sa stock market. So hindi pa po huli ang lahat. So ang ating mga stock prices ay talagang for sale pa po. So nagsisimula na pong umangat ang Pilipinas. May nabasa ako kanina sa Facebook na talagang ayan. So sabi po dito, make sure po na ang ating mga source ng ating mga balita ay tama para hindi po tayo ma-fake news. So ayan po, dito po sa Dwiz 882, actually ito po ay radio station. So, unti-unti nang bumabalik ang pagsigla ng ekonomiya ng bansa sa gitna ng patuloy na paglaban sa pandemya COVID-19 ayon sa Department of Trade and Industry. So, ayan po, may pag-asa po na ang ating mga red portfolio ay magiging green later on. So, ayan, by October, may maganda pong magaganap. So, there will be a jackpot for all of us. So, ayan po. So, hindi pa huli ang lahat. September pa po. So, wag na po tayo magpahuli. So, laban na to. So, maraming salamat po. Hanggang sa muli. Okay, so ako po si John Molina sa Nurse Trader TV. So, i-like nyo lamang po, subscribe, and of course, for us to get an update for our new videos, click nyo lamang po ang bell button. So, maraming salamat po. Hanggang sa muli.